Hi, this is James Cook of the University of Maine at Augusta, and today we're going to use NodeXL to connect to Twitter so that we can obtain Twitter search data. Now, this technique will work for either NodeXL or NodeXL Pro, the new for-pay full version of NodeXL that the Social Media Research Foundation has created. To get started, you're going to want to create a Twitter account at twitter.com. It's free, and you don't actually have to use Twitter in order to do that. Then go to Import Twitter Search Network in NodeXL and select that, and you'll see an Import Search box. Now, in that Import Search box, you'll want to enter a search term. I'm going to enter hashtag ME politics. A hashtag is a subject, and ME politics stands for Maine politics. I'm going to select that I have a Twitter account, but I haven't authorized NodeXL to use it yet. And then I'm going to limit to 500 tweets, and I will also select the expand URLs in tweets. A tweet is a Twitter post, and a URL is a web address. So after you have obtained an absolutely free Twitter account at twitter.com, and after you have entered this data, you'll be ready to click OK. Now, once you hit OK, you'll be automatically taken to a web page that asks NodeXL to use your Twitter account. That just simply connects the back end of NodeXL to the back end of Twitter so they can speak to one another. It won't be able to post tweets for you, so go ahead, click that blue authorize app button and then select the 7-digit number and hit Control C for copy to put that in your clipboard. Head back to NodeXL and you'll see there's a pop-up box that's asking for you to paste in that PIN. So since you're on Windows, you can hit Control V once you click on the box to paste in that PIN number. Of course, you could just write it down on a sheet of paper and then type it in as well. Then hit OK. And lo and behold, you'll notice that this import box says that it is getting a list of tweets. It was that easy. You're in business. You are actually now mining the social web. You're collecting social media data, and that makes you a social media researcher. What you want to do with it is up to you. And of course, every one of these Twitter searches will take a few minutes to complete. But once you've got that data, you're ready to go. I look forward, if you're a student of mine, to seeing your work. And otherwise, I hope to see your work perhaps someday in print. Best of luck to you and your work now that you know how to make that connection.